fans, once again, it's the Horror Miser Monty G. It's about time I do a tag video. I haven't done a tag video in a while because right now this is going to be a non-horror tag because it's going to talk about top comedians that I like. Now I was tagged by my good friend Jennifer from Jennifer Reviews from the Craig. Her and Christian came up with this tag talking about some of their favorite comedians of all time. And they mentioned a lot of good comedians. Some of them I like, some of them, they have particular tastes in humor and might be different than mine, but they did tag me, so I want to talk about some of the greatest comedians I've seen in my lifetime. Now, obviously, I'm going to go back from the 70s, and perhaps some people might know him, some people might not know, but the great Red Fox from Sanford and Son was a great comedian in his time. There was one particular album that he did called Gotta Wash Your Ass, because he did this bit on it where he talked about funky-ass people that stank all the time. He said, you gotta wash your ass, and he's right, too. I mean, put it this way, what you like, especially in this heat wave that we just got over with, and you stand next to some funky-ass person who didn't put on any deodorant in his goddamn heat wave, it's like, what the fuck is your problem? You couldn't even spend a dollar for a deodorant? Oh, come on. Wash your ass, please. Obviously, you can't talk about the 70s in comedy when it came to good old, the late, great Richard Pryor. Richard Pryor was a very funny man. I liked most of the movies that he did when he was making movies, but obviously, he was a great stand-up comedian. Yeah, he had his troubles and went through a lot of shit during his time period. I remember the two interviews that he did on Barbara Walters when he actually admitted the first time when he unfortunately lit himself on fire because he was, at that time, freebasing before it became known as smoking crack. And eventually the second time he was on Barbara Walters, he had told her that he lied to her. And he came with a nice excuse because his manager told him, I think that the story goes right, he said that the manager and the press said one thing to cover Richard's ass. So, and the second time when he came on, what you call me, he said, I had to cover his ass. So that's one, that's the only reason why he said he told her that story. But then he admitted the truth, that the fact that, yeah, he was freebasing. Freebasing, that's what's known of it back then. But yeah, obviously, the late, great Richard Pryor. Now, here's a couple that might actually surprise people. Obviously, one of the greatest comedians that I used to listen to, I thought, was obviously Rodney Dangerfield, the man who gave nobody respect. Yeah, good old Rodney Dangerfield. Yeah, he was quite funny back when he was doing his stand-up comedians, but yeah, good old Rodney Dangerfield. You can't leave him out as a stand-up comedian. Now, obviously, this next guy will probably bring some controversy, but I'm pretty sure people remember Andrew Dice Clay. Andrew Dice Clay, yeah, he caused some controversy, but how can you forget those awesome poems that he used to do? I actually first saw him in Rodney Dangerfield comedy show back on, I think it was maybe the mid to late 80s at the time. I know it was on HBO. He had a series of young comics on there, and Andrew Dice Clay was one of them. And he would come up on stage, lit the cigarette up, and just told a bunch of nasty-ass nursery rhymes. And some of them were funny. Unfortunately, if he were to say that type of comedy today, he would get ridiculed and laughed off the stage. And some other comedians, some of the stuff that they did, which I'll probably list in. There's one in particular I can think about. I'll talk about him later. But, yeah, Andrew Dice Clay. Another late, great comedian that came off of Rodney Dangerfield was Sam Kinison. Yeah, Sam Kinison, the real loud and very funny comedian. Always had an interesting relationship with Howard Stern. He used to be good buddies, and all of a sudden they were enemies. But then eventually, before, unfortunately, his untimely death, they became friends again. And Sam Kinison was an awesome comedian. It's a shame that his life was cut short. Partying too hard, you know, so I guess was mainly led to his death. But yeah, Sam Kinison, who could forget? See, this is sad. Are you gonna eat? Can you grow anything? You live in a fucking desert. Now, obviously, there are some female comics that I like. One of them would be Wanda Sykes. Wanda Sykes is a very funny woman. It was interesting how her life has been. She's been she was I think he's maybe sometimes on with Damon Wayans. I think he might have discovered her. I forget if I didn't really take a look at her background. But, yeah, she was a very funny woman, and she's had some funny lines. She used to do a bit on the NFL, this week in the NFL when it was on HBO. And she's a very funny lady. I like the laughs of her stand-up comedian. So, Wanda Sykes. This also probably gets some criticism, but I actually do like Kathy Griffin. I think she is funny. Yeah, she could be a little out there sometimes, but that's just her being Kathy Griffin. I like how she used to mess with Cooper and Anderson Cooper, especially on those New Year's Eve shows. Unfortunately, due to some controversy she did, she's no longer on those shows. But yeah, Kathy Griffin, I think she actually is funny, and I did like some of her comedy. All right, time to get to a little bit more modern times. Obviously, another comedian that I truly love was Chris Rock. Yes, Chris Rock. He had a couple of albums right there. There was one in particular song that he did with Gerald Everett called There's No Sex. Yes, the song was called There's No Sex in the Champagne Room. None. Then you had Gerald Everett singing the song. Yeah, nice little beat to it, too, yes. And, of course, he did his little nice bit where he read horoscopes and told everyone, you're going to die. Gemini, you're going to die twice. Scorpio, you're going to die. Fuck it. Shit was funny. I still laugh at that. Now, of course, you have Kevin Hart. Now, Kevin Hart is a bit different for me. He can be funny at times, but he tends to do the same thing all the time, especially in his movies, which is okay. But then again, sometimes it's not okay because he seems to be repeating the same thing that he's done in mostly all of his comedy bits. Don't get me wrong, it's still funny as hell. I like some of his movies. I like the stuff he did with The Rock. I like him, his tandem with that he does. In certain of the movies that he's been in, but you know, he's still funny when he does his stand-up. So, Kevin Hart. The next comedian I want to talk about is Dave Chappelle. Dave Chappelle was a very funny guy, and he could have been an up-and-coming guy had he not gotten to the problem that he did before, but, you know, I feel kind of sorry for him because I love the Dave Chappelle show on Comedy Central. He was a very funny guy, had some nice bits. And it's a shame. So hopefully he can come back and be the comedian that he was always wanted. Now, of course, you cannot talk comedy when you can. Don't mention the Kings of Comedy. Yes, that nice little bit that had Steve Harvey, Cedric the Entertainer, the late, great Bernie Mac, and D.L. Hughley. That was a funny bit. I love all those guys. They were all funny, especially the late, great Bernie Mac. The guy was just funny. And he's sorely missed. But, yeah, Steve Harvey, Cedric the Entertainer, you know, they're still funny. I still like, Steve Harvey. He's kind of old school. He'll talk about back when it was back in the day, and I love those all bits. And he'll get real crazy. And he talks about the difference between what's going on now and how it was back when he grew up, which is probably similar to how I grew up back in the day, because back in the day, your mom whipped your ass. Plain and simple. Yeah, my mother, you know, anytime I got in trouble, yeah, my mom got the belt whipped my ass, because that's what women did back in the 70s when I grew up at that time. And he'll mention that time in the war, too. You know, you get an ass whipping. And, of course, last but not least, can't talk about comedy without talking about Eddie Murphy. Eddie Murphy was the man after Saturday Night Live, and he did his couple movies with Nick Nolte in 48 Hours, and eventually he got his own in Beverly Hills Cop, and he was great in the stand-up routines. Obviously, for me, was not the Raw that was actually filmed in theaters and was released in theaters. There was a black market Raw that he did in Washington, D.C., where I don't know if anyone can ever find it, but one of my best friends got the tape, and he had some excellent bits on there, and there's one bit where he talks like Bill Cosby. Oh, boy. And he goes at the end, he says, "And what I expected to hear our family entertainment, you go on and save the words, fuck you, motherfucker, and suck my dick, and filth, flying filth, and filth, flying filth, and to get a dribble up your ass, you gotta use breadcrumbs." You can't say it. Shit was funny. Oh man, I loved it. Now, of course, obviously, some of the stuff that Eddie Murphy said then, he could not say it now. He would be vilified because of PC, political correctness. So some of the stuff that he did before, which was hilariously funny, because everyone talked about it, but unfortunately right now, you can't get away with that. There's simply no way in the world. So I wouldn't know how Eddie would survive the day. But yeah, the great Eddie Murphy, one of my favorite comedians. So that's it. That's the comedy tag right there. Once again, I want to thank Jen from Jen Reviews from the Grave for tagging me on this particular video. Now, normally, this is the point of the video where I'm supposed to tag other people. But normally, what I do is this. If you're watching this video right now, you've been officially been tagged by the Horror by Sarmani G. I'm going to leave Jen's link to her channel in the description box below as well. So that way, if you're going to do the tag, make sure you do give her the credit because this is her tag. So once again, that's my video for today, folks. Hope you enjoyed. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up. And if this is your first time here, please hit that subscriber button and ring that notification bell. That way you're notified anytime when I put up any new material on the channel, be it something like this, a horror review, unboxing, trailer reaction videos, or anything horror related. Once again, my name is Lamont Smith, better known as the Horror Miser Mani G, and always remember your rules. Gerald LaVert and Chris, take us home. We're out.
No matter what a stripper says, there's no sex in the champagne room. None.
No sex in the champagne room. No sex in the champagne room.